Now, if you're looking for something separate from your phone when it comes to photography, look no further. In today's video, I'm going to be sharing with you some great cameras that are worth checking out in the time of this video when it comes to first-time photography, and let's crack on. First, looking at the 1300D, which is a great 20-megapixel camera, interchangeable lenses, really nice sensor. Let's have a look. Look at that view. What I like about these, they feel nice, they look professional, you can change the lenses depending on the versatility or the situation that you're looking for. They have a nice viewfinder so you can see what you're doing, which is really nice. Flash on the top, you can attach it to a tripod, making it even better, set it on a timer, taking that perfect photo, whatever it is that you're taking photos of. Now, as a beginner, I would massively recommend put it into beginner mode and just let the camera do the heavy lifting for you. Now, if you feel a bit more, you know, daredevil with the camera, you can definitely go to settings, play with shutter speed and ISO, and off you go. Now, they do have a nice little screen on the back so you can see what you're taking photos of. I personally like to do that because I come from a background of point and shoot, but if you're a bit more old school and you just want to see exactly what you're taking a photo of, feel more professional, the viewfinder definitely could be for you. Now, what I like about these cameras, they have lots of different settings for all different situations, for close-ups and mountains in the background, making these cameras really nice to check out. If you have any questions about any of the cameras I talk about today, feel free to ask your questions in the comments below, and there will be links to all these cameras also in the description. Now, what else is there to say about this camera? Very nice and agile, not too heavy, feels professional, nice to hold, and really is a nice camera. Now, the 1300D has actually been replaced by the 2000D that some of you may or may not already know or have, and they are great cameras. They basically did a newer version, basically does everything better. And then there's really nice little cameras. They feel really nice to hold and that sort of thing. So this is sort of the first camera I'll definitely look at checking out. And you can get one of these for sort of about £200-£300 or dollars, depending on what part of the world you're in, what day of the week it is, because prices massively vary, especially online, I've noticed. But luckily, if you've got any questions, I'll do my best to answer them. And if you want to change the battery's on the bottom. A little power tip I definitely share. If you start out, definitely have a spare battery. Batteries are good with these cameras, but it's always nice to have a spare battery and a tripod, because that can hold the camera so you can put your camera on the timer, take that perfect photo. And I personally always say that the tripod is definitely your best friend. Now, if you're getting value so far from this video, don't forget to like and subscribe. And I'm Dave from TVR Creators, and I make weekly content on the best cameras for creators and beginners. If that sounds interesting to you, don't forget to like and subscribe. Now, the next sort of set of cameras I would check out is something like the M100 or the M200. You can get these for sort of £200-£300, sometimes more, but sometimes you get a very good deal on the M100 for about £150-£200, which is great as a first-time camera. Now, what I like about this is actually a mirrorless camera, 24 megapixel. Again, interchangeable lenses, though they do have a small range of lenses, but you can extend that with a mount. What I like about this, it does have a nice little flip screen, so these can do video as well, but also when you're taking that photo, maybe doing a selfie of your family and stuff, it's just an easy way to see exactly what's going on, just like you would on your phone. And what I like about these little cameras is they're lighter, they're more compact, they actually take better pictures in my personal opinion, and they're very easy to use. It's video, photo mode, you know, you can play around with shutter speed and ISO if you wish, but I just love the fact that you can literally just carry these around. I have done on days out, and they're just nice little cameras. They feel professional and they take really nice photos and all sorts of light. Little power tip. When you're taking the SD card out, you have to pull the screen back a little bit, but that's just a minor thing. Make sure you get a strap. Now, usually with any of these cameras, you will come with a battery and a strap and the kit lens. This is actually the 15-45mm, which is actually the same lens I'm actually using to film today's video, which is something to bear in mind. And I just love these cameras. Now, the M200 does things slightly better. You can actually use that for live streaming if that's what you're into, but obviously we're looking more at photography today. But these take really nice photos. I've actually used this camera for taking multiple thumbnails, photos on days out, or just of the cameras I'm using. And I'm really, really happy with this camera. It's a really nice set of cameras, this range is. And it does everything you like. It has a flash on the top, easy access photo button, timer as well. And it does everything you want to do, especially as a first time camera user, if you want something separate from your phone. Definitely hit like and subscribe if you're getting value. But I don't know, I love these cameras. They're really compact and they do everything you want to do easily and fast. And a little power tip just before going to the next set of cameras, you can actually tell it to focus on a certain object, which I really like. tap the object again and it takes a photo really quickly, which is really nice. I absolutely love that. So this is definitely a set of cameras I would definitely check out. If you're enjoying the content today, don't forget, why not buy us a coffee? Links down in the description below, and I really would appreciate and thank you in advance for those of you that have done already. It just means a lot and supports everything we do here on the channel. Now the next camera I want to show you guys is the Canon R100, which actually replaced the M200, and these are great cameras. Again, interchangeable lenses, does everything fast. I love the shutter speed of these cameras, so if you're going on the day trip watching fast cars, you can click 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 click, and it really does take some powerful photos, which is really nice to see. And you can do video with this as well. It has a nice little touch screen, even has a mic jack if you want to record the family. It has a viewfinder, which is really nice. You can attach a microphone or a bigger flash. It has its own flash, internal microphone, interchangeable lenses. It does everything the other cameras do, but even better. Now, you get one of these for about sort of $400 or $500, sometimes a bit more. Again, depends on the day of the week. So if you find a camera you like, my massive power tip today is follow it for about a week and get a rough idea of the price, because honestly, especially online, prices do change a lot. Again, you should get the lens, a battery, a strap. They'll have it connected, a strap to this one. I just haven't got around to it. But these are really powerful cameras. If you want something that really future-proofs yourself, feels really professional, takes really nice photos, I'll definitely check out the R100. Absolutely great camera from Canon. And it's a 24.2 megapixel camera. And the lens, the sensor on it, takes really nice photos. And again, you can use this for video if you want. It has a really nice lens on it, so it does take really nice video. But this is just a great camera. A camera I would massively recommend. And my favorite camera is actually the R50, which takes great photos, pretty much the same as this, but has a flip screen, and which makes it better for video. But these are definitely cameras are worth definitely all checking out. Again, if you have any questions, feel free to ask your questions in the comments below. And I just want to say, happy photography. Enjoy what you do. Whatever camera you choose to get, even if you're using your phone, experiment with what it can do. Enjoy the adventure. And feel free to share your stories of photography. It'd just be really nice to see the comments below. And in a moment, I'm going to share with you two end cards, which you can probably see on the screen already, that will give you even more value. Go and click on one of those videos and see what else you can check out. Because I'm Dave from TVR Creators, and I'll see you in the next video. Why? Because you guys rock.